The following has been rated PC for politically correct.
Pay attention, you just may learn something.
It's the Sage, Larry Elder.
By the way, Chief Justice Roberts was annoyed by the liberal justices who dissented, who tried to compare this travel ban to the order issued by FDR that interned Japanese Americans during World War II. Roberts said the internment order has nothing to do with this case. It is wholly inapt to liken that morally repugnant order to a facially neutral policy denying certain foreign nationals the privilege of admission. Close quote. He could say the same thing about people using the same metaphor, internment metaphor, describing the separation of the children on the border who were put in centers temporarily while their parents' legal status is being adjudicated. And a number of people have likened it to a concentration camp, to a death camp, Michael Hayden did, to an internment camp. Chief Justice Roberts said as to that comparison to the travel ban, it is wholly inapt to liken that morally repugnant order to a facially neutral policy. The same thing could be said to all of these people who are making those kinds of references regarding the separation that's taking place on the southern border. Take MSNBC Haw's Ali Velshi.
So we are actually used to this. And if we go back sociologically into our history, we have done this to the poor. We did it to slaves, right? We just decided that families were not important. It was a way to weaken people. You could actually separate families. So we've got some deep-rooted cultural understanding of families that is not shared by the rest of the world.
What was that? We did it to slaves? You're likening economic migrants voluntarily coming to America, leaving their own countries, entering the country illegally. President has a policy that illegal border crossers are going to be prosecuted as criminals. You can't put the children in jail with them. So they are temporarily separated while their status of the parents is being adjudicated. And that is akin to what we did with slaves.
So we are actually used to this. And if we go back sociologically into our history, we have done this to the poor. We did it to slaves, right? We just decided that families were not important.
And Steve Schmidt, who I believe is a Republican, calls himself a Republican. Same thing. Listen to this.
One of the few times he says, this is it. And it is giving a cup of water in the master's name, feeding the hungry, clothing the naked, visiting those in prison, and again, helping the least among us.
Don't hate the messenger.
This is Jesus talking.
The extraordinary and astounding hypocrisy of it. Yeah. To see the constancy of the assertion of Christian virtue by political leaders in this country who have established internment camps for babies and toddlers. And by the way,
internment camps. It is wholly inapt to liken that morally repugnant order to a facially neutral policy, denying certain foreign nationals the privilege of admission. The same thing could be said about what Mr. Schmidt and what Mr. Velshi just said. Outrageous. This business of Trump voters and how Trump is turning them into Cujo. That's pretty much what they think.
If you vote for Trump, then you, the voter, you, not Donald Trump, are standing at the border like Nazis, going, you here, you here. And I think we now have to flip it. And it's a given, the evilness of Donald Trump.
If you hold down the woman while the rapist is raping her, and you didn't rape her, are you a rapist?
Tens of millions of people voted for him after he showed his cards for years.
But are you suggesting that they're racist? The people who voted for Donald Trump are racist.
Yes.
Yeah. If Republicans weren't so racist, they could encourage black people who are morally conservative to be on their side.
Those people who are supporting what he's doing here
are racist, period.
It's just movements and people that are speaking up for things, whether we're talking about civil rights movement, whatever else, those movements should be nonviolent, but they should not be non-confrontational.
And so these policies that this administration is putting forth are intentionally cruel, they are racist, and it is our job as citizens to speak out against that.
White lash.
If you vote for Trump, then you, the voter, you, not Donald Trump, are standing at the border like Nazis going, you here, you here. And I think we now have to flip it. And it's a given, the evilness of Donald Trump.
If barbaric. You hold down the woman while the rapist is raping her, and you didn't rape her, are you a rapist?
Right.
Tens of millions of people voted for him after he showed his cards for years.
But are you, are you suggesting that they're racist? Or they're
yes.
The people who vote, all the people who voted for Donald Trump.
Yes.
Yeah. If Republicans weren't so racist, they could encourage black people who are morally conservative to be on their side.
Those people who are supporting what he's doing here are racist, period.
White lash. People that are speaking up for things, whether we're talking about civil rights movement, whatever else, those movements should be nonviolent, but they should not be non-confrontational.
And so these policies that this administration is putting forth are intentionally cruel, they are racist, and it is our job as citizens to speak out against that. Now, does that mean that we're going to be violent? No. But does that mean that Sarah Sanders can have a nice, quiet dinner with her family when she's taking our tax dollars to implement this policy? I don't think so.
Anybody who votes for and supports a racist is a racist. You are culpable, white America. I'm sorry.
Is it complicit or either you're enabling?
But you guys are involved with being patriotic, right?
Very, very patriotic, but not...
Being patriotic was the group that contacted and helped organize some of these activities that you posted on your own Facebook account.
Those were legitimate.
Those were Russians.
They were not Russians. I don't go with the Russians.
Out very clearly what his interests are.
President Walker, how do you resist the temptation to run up and wring her neck?
25% of the country, whether it's 25, 20, 30%, are hardcore racists. They do not want to see brown people coming into America. That's just what's going on here. I mean,
of certain individuals and institutions, we will, as per Chief Jim Hopper, punch some people in the face when they seek to destroy and we will do it all with soul, with heart, and with joy.
There are still generations of people, older people, who were born and bred and marinated in it. In
Excuse
that prejudice and racism, and they just have to die.
A lot of the supporters believe that we are the enemy of the American people, and that is really, really an awful situation. We are not the enemy of the American people.
It wasn't rape.
Is there a brain in there?
You are out of order. Shut up.
Excuse me?
Can you feel the love?